And we see here in Soho Street and in Oxford Street many people coming up and down. But they miss this place because it's not on the map for tourists. If you come to London, they see the big wheel going around and Buckingham Palace and other things, but they don't even hear Radha Londonishvara. So they're missing the whole point. London is meant for Radha Londonishvara.
Here we are, Srila Prabhupada, in the very place that you called hell, London. We're taking shelter of your most beloved Sri Sri Radha Londonishvara, Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra, Giri Govardhan and Gaurani Thai. We are chanting the holy names, distributing your books, and feeding hundreds of people Krishna Prasad every day. We are endeavoring to build a community of sincere Vaishnavas dedicated to your ISKCON mission, and we are desperately trying to cooperate in such a way that you become pleased. We want to glorify you, Srila Prabhupada, for all that you have given to this world. You have blessed us all in so many ways with so many gifts of love and support. You have given us the process, hearing and chanting. You have given us the mission, preach in every town and village. You have given us the reason, compassion. You have given us the opportunity to go back to Godhead. You have given us Krishna, the all-attractive Supreme Personality of Godhead. How can we ever repay you for this, Srila Prabhupada?
Why is a temple in central London so important to Srila Prabhupada? First of all, it was important to his own spiritual master, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, who sent a few of his sannyasi disciples to London. Also, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the seventh canto, which is a portion of the Bhagavatam that Srila Prabhupada spoke from often, and which he quoted often, Prahlad Maharaj says to Lord Nisringadev, "I see that there are many saintly persons who are very interested in their own deliverance, but very few saintly persons who are interested in going to the big cities and towns to deliver others." So Srila Prabhupada was not that kind who's not interested or who's only interested in his own deliverance. Srila Prabhupada was interested in delivering as many people as possible. Therefore, he wanted to put our temples and our centers right smack in the middle of what he called the most congested areas, where are the greatest number of people.
It's explained that in the spiritual world, every day is a festival, that every word is a song and every step is a dance. So when devotees come together and sing and dance for the pleasure of their lordships, then great, wonderful, and amazing things happen. Everyone experiences the real nectar that's there on offer in the spiritual world.
Festivals have become huge, so big they've completely outgrown the building. They had already outgrown the building, but now they've really outgrown the building.
This is the chef, Mata Jindira, and she's making some pakora, and me, I'm trying to make some gulab jamun.
And we have Mother Sarasvati, who is also from in the ladies' ashram. She stays here. She makes amazing cakes for Sri Sri Radha Londonishvara.
So this year we've really been trying to focus on improving the festivals and facilitating more numbers of devotees who come to visit.
The festivals are more exciting, more fun. They can come and enjoy themselves.
Wonderful pastimes. So this Govardhan Hill is so special. Giriraj Maharaj Ki Jai! But above Govardhan is Radha-Kund. It's explained that on this planet, this is the topmost place, topmost spiritual place on the planet. Because this is the place of the amorous pastimes between Srimati Radharani and Krishna. So the topmost of all the devotees of the Lord is Srimati Radharani.
Everybody gets involved, not all the devotees who live in outside, all the congregational members.
The festivals are fully sponsored by the congregation now, all the costs. And mostly, they're operated by the congregation members too.
That the numbers at Rath Yatra have been increasing over the years. More and more people are taking part and enjoying the Yatra. And it's a very good example for the movement when people see. The police see, they say, oh my God, you know, people coming together in huge numbers, but it's so peaceful, so nice, so enjoyable. So even they appreciate. So it's a very good medium to give out Krishna consciousness.
We had great success this year for Jamashtami. We had, throughout the day, probably approximately 2,000 devotees come and visit the temple. And around midnight, for the midnight darshan, we had about 800 devotees probably on the premises or come through for the darshan, take prasad, and then go.
In central London, in Soho, it's not very conducive for spiritual life. Unless we're preaching Krishna consciousness.
Everybody really needs to study these books, whether they're living in the temple or they just come to the temple once a week, because knowledge is the foundation of everything. If you don't have the knowledge of Krishna and who he is, then we can have no faith in him, and faith is the beginning of Krishna consciousness.
It is a service to study Prabhupada's books. Every inch of this temple is valuable, is extremely valuable, and it has to be used for the best possible purpose.
We have about 12 or 13 devotees who are studying Bhakti Shastri this year. It's a part-time course, and the aim is that these devotees do the Bhakti Shastri this year and will finish next year in 2007.
College preaching is also very important. We also want to develop the schools programs, and even at some point, actually, we should be thinking of education for our own children. And in central London, that would be very important.
I teach them different things which they need to do when they come in the temple. And then we have presentations which are usually very interactive, in which they are participating. We dress up also some girls, you know, like as the Dwaraka citizens and princesses. And some other boys we dress also in the dhotis and kurtas, and they are, you know, priests or something like that. And then we have all Bhagavad Gita drama. And the end of the drama, when Krishna and Arjuna are coming back, then all classroom is participating. If I go to the schools, then it's a little bit different, because my desire is when I go to the schools that I create a temple in the classroom and put the throws on the floor and decorate all the classroom with the mandalas and different decorations. Man Biharini went with me several times, also Dunya went with me.
Thank you, dear Prana Haribo, thank you so much for everything. I felt like we were in a real temple. Everything was so colorful and pretty. That was the best religious education lesson in the world. And thank you so much again from Anna and Mimi. It's like that. It's really heart-touching letters.
We have more congregational members doing more. Besides giving donations, they're doing more volunteer service, a lot of service, which is taking a lot of pressure off the temple devotees. And giving the temple devotees more facility for more time for preaching.
Many people who are inspired by the restaurant, who come to the restaurant and they like it.
The sales in Govinda's restaurant have never been so high. We broke our sales record twice this year. First in June, we broke 40,000 pounds a month, and then in August, 43,000.
It is, it's love and devotion, and because the food is offered to Krishna with such love and devotion, it has a very powerful impact on those who eat it. We have a very stable restaurant manager, Sudhatma Prabhu, who's resilient and determined.
Sudhatma Prabhu came in Govinda's the same year, at the end of 2001. And very soon he became one of the main manager in the restaurant. From one side, he is Brahmana. From second hand, he was like Vaishya vision. Oh, this is very good price for us. We have to take this drink for selling. This is not good for us because nobody will buy this. This is very good prasadam that everyone appreciated. The kitchen staff, some of devotees start even earlier than 5 o'clock.
We're serving around 300 to 500 plates of prasad every day.
Food for life distribution. That's increasing. Great number of students, young students, especially who are coming from abroad, you know, they find it great to be part of the food distribution team.
We've got many customers who bring other customers, their friends, because they want to share their pleasure. You see, I know this, but you still don't know. Please come with me. And they become our regular customers as well.
We're very hopeful that the restaurant can continue to grow and remain a very dynamic part of Soho Street's preaching.
Prabhupada spoke so much about book distribution. He said that these temples are not a place for eating and sleeping, but a base from which we send out our soldiers to fight with Maya. And to fight with Maya means to drop hundreds of thousands of books into the laps of the conditioned souls, just like in wartime, the bombs are raining from the sky, Prabhupada said. So this is our mission, this is our purpose.
As it's described, that the associates of Lord Chaitanya were his soldiers, and that is Srivas, Nityananda, Advaita Acharya is like generals, and you know, Prabhupada is often referred to as a Sankirtan general. And often the books are compared to bombs, time bombs, that can go off at any second. I never met a devotee. I got the book in a cafe, someone left it on the table, and then I got it and it went off.
Prabhupada always says that book distribution is our main activity, and he said that his books will be the lower books of mankind for the next 10,000 years. So you can see how important book distribution is.
And if you give somebody a book, it stays with them. Prabhupada said that books are as good as deities. So when they enter into somebody's house, it's the same as having Krishna there in their home. And just by seeing that book, Bhagavatam explains that this is the literary incarnation of God. It's non-different than Krishna.
So the four full-time book distributors are Tarun Krishna Prabhu, who is the Sankirtan leader, Subal Prabhu, who's been doing book distribution now for coming up to 7 years solid, Bhakti Sean from Ireland, and Bhakti Joan Mark.
And then we have Mother Sharada, who's doing book distribution at lunchtime every day, usually. And then we have the congregation who come out once a month on Mahasaturday Sankirtan, the last Saturday of each month.
9.45 book points. Bhakti Sean Prabhu collected 55 Lakshmi points. Distributing 30 small books, 7 big books for 11.5 book points.
My activities in the temple were sleeping, honoring prasadam, chanting Hare Krishna, kirtan, a little bit of pujari service, playing madanga, reading, studying, and also 5-6 days a week I go out and distribute BBT publications, mostly written by Srila Prabhupada on Oxford Street and surrounding areas. I tell people they're the ultimate home entertainment system. People spend thousands of pounds on DVDs and MP3s, TVs, big, you know, screens and PlayStations. What's a new one? PSP, Game Boy, a dual screen, and they spend so much money on CDs. But all you need is a set of Srila Prabhupada's books. All you need is Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita. That's for the big sets, just a few hundred pounds. It'll keep you going for the rest of your life.
So yeah, it's a very blissful activity, and to not do it is very difficult. Once you've got that taste, and then you have to go and do something else, like for myself, I have to do some management or stay back some days. It's very difficult to not go out. It's so blissful. So I recommend everybody to get that taste.
Well, if you go on Oxford Street, there's no old people hardly. All the people are kind of good-looking, trendies, and they think they're happy. They've got their youth, their health, they've got money, or they've got a credit card at least. And so it's, you know, you need to be convinced that these people need Krishna.
And I'd like to do travelling Sankirtan to get a motor home and to go out with the devotees in that facility, because although this is a wonderful temple, there's many different things that are going on. So for travelling Sankirtan, then it's just 3 or 4 of you living in a van, and that's all you do.
The claim ridangas that we have, we can just sound it and it will just sound in the room here. But book distribution is a Brihat Mridanga. It is being sounded all over the world and purifying the lives of many, like thousands of people every day.
There's a special reciprocation there from Krishna because the preaching is so solid. Yeah, there's nothing so ecstatic as giving somebody a book.
Every day they would arrest us, and we had big fines, £5 each, so maybe at least 10, 12 devotees, so that was like £60 a day in fines. And we were locked up to take our names, and so we had so many Sankirtan pastimes with the police, avoiding the police, running from the police, going to the magistrate's court, until eventually what happened was that Tribhuvana managed to present the books to the magistrate. So he read the books, and then he had some realization that these people are actually saints. They're actually monks. They're actually preaching, you know. They're doing the police's work for them. So the next time they brought us to the court, the magistrate chastised the police. He said, "Why are you bringing these people? They're doing your work. Your work for you. You know, they're simply preaching about God. Whilst you're bringing them, so many criminals are going free. So please don't bring these people anymore." So after that, then, they left us alone, the police. Now they appreciate it. Now we're a tourist attraction.
Harinams are really wonderful because there's one bhajan that explains that chanting the holy name is the essence of all religion. When people chant the holy name, then, you know, when people like see chanting on the street, or, you know, they clap their hands or they enjoy it a little bit, then they're taking part in the, you know, the highest, like, perfectional stage of spiritual life.
You should desire to do Krishna Prema Harina. When the people see devotees, they'll be like, wow, fainting, crying, you know. So, because it was like this in Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's times and also in times of Srila Prabhupada. So this is what we would like to go for it, not just only Namabhas Harinam, you know. We'd like to pure chanting.
This year Harinam is improved because now more temple residents are going on Harinam on a regular basis. And now we have prasadam being distributed on the Harinams and also book distribution is happening on the Harinams.
Our vision for this temple is to flood London with Krishna consciousness. Well, to flood London with Krishna consciousness, we need a lot more propagating of Krishna consciousness going on, which means more Harinam parties.
Harinam is glorious.
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Srila Prabhupada has established all these temples to give out bhakti. That is the outreach from these temples. And if we want to do that, then we have to have the facilities, you know, to do that. And one of them means space.
We just recently, just a few days ago, moved into the first floor of the building next door, moved offices there, which we're leasing.
Those devotees who are having to work in the administration of the building, they'll have their own space. There won't be the normal interruptions that occur throughout the day in the current building that we're in.
It's amazing. This is history. Here, come with me. I'll show you all around. It's like this. It took us 27 years of this. This is going to be the meeting room where we meet with very important people when we take over London. And this is going to be the education department. We're going to help spread education and guidance, spiritual education and guidance for the whole of London. This is Bhakta Ramdas's office, because he's going to need a lot of space so he can deal with the large financial income that we create from spreading Krishna consciousness. Here's storage. You can see we're not very good at
and it's already full.
It's full already. This is going to be for Govinda's restaurant. You get the vault. This is for Tapas Prabhu. He's counting all the Lakshmi. This is a nice room. This is going to be the art studio. But we're not sure what's going to happen with the art department because Vishwapamani Prabhu left. Krishna, to send someone with artistic. If you're artistic and you want to work for us, this is your office. Okay. And see, this is equal rights. Ladies do all the work and the ladies wander. This is Mother Sanya Vandana's office. She takes care of all the financial administration.
And she's fast.
This is her. She's very good.
Thank you. Have bigger facilities because we like to have bigger preaching.
The plan to take the floor next door for the offices as a step forward in the right direction. But if Krishna sees that we can handle that, then he may be ready to give us more.
Srila Prabhupada established the standards that we have at Shishirada Londonishvara temple for the worship of the deities. And in the beginning, he made these standards very simple. And in this way, we try to follow these basic standards while always increasing and improving them.
Radha Londonishvara are very dear to Srila Prabhupada. They're very beautiful as well, so they do attract a lot of people. And so we try and bring people in closer.
Red color, Krishna. Red color jewelry here. This is for. So also this one.
Living in the temple, we have Vrindavan Prabhu, who comes from Vrindavan, and he's a very stalwart devotee, a very hard worker.
At the moment, he was like 55 dresses, which we put every day, you know, the new different one.
This one is Radha Krishna. It's Radha Londonishvara edition. Oh, yeah, this is my favorite dress. Very, very good. And red titan. So very, very my favorite dress. Huh? You like this one?
Mother Rama Shakti, she takes complete care of the garlands, the vases, and all the flowers. Yeah, she takes complete care of that. And she does a wonderful job in that. Some persons have commented that The garlands here are some of the best they've ever seen. Yeah, she puts a lot into it. It takes a lot of work because we try and match our garlands with our outfits. And she does a wonderful job there, and she engages many other ladies as well in helping her. We have Mother Vimala as well. She's very dedicated. She's been rendering service here for over 20 years, and she's very dedicated to her service, and she does an amazing amount of service. We also have a devotee from the Philippines named Julio Cusho, another brahmachari. He is what is known as a head pujari's dream because he's very hard-working, and he's very simple. He does his service, he does it very well.
Yeah, it's very nice to do service there because yeah, you can really feel, no? When you do service there, you feel you are doing really for Krishna because it's just close to the altar, no? The Puyari area is just there close, very close. Then automatically we feel, it's for Krishna. We do whatever we do, yeah, it's for Krishna, like that. And it's nice also to engage, no? And new devotees are coming to do service. Then sometimes many of the devotees, they do service there for first time. They get very surprised. No, they say, "Oh, how I am able to do service here? Oh, I didn't know Krishna is so kind, engage me in his service." No, they really get what's that sense of gratitude.
The main core of our full-time pujaris is perhaps only three or four devotees, and the rest is made up with members of the congregation who actually come in.
Also, Prabhupada explains about the dual tracks of devotional service, Bhagavat Vidhi and Pancharatrika Vidhi, so that one means deity service and the other means preaching, chanting, hearing. So they need to go on hand in hand. So we're all part of the deity service here. We need to be conscious of the deities and become purified.
Prabhupada called the deities Radha, Londonishvara, so it seems like they're hidden Ishwaras. So you know, there's a kind of mandate that Prabhupada given in the name that we should make them Ishwaras, make them very prominent. Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. My deep desire is that actually Krishna consciousness will inspire all other temples all over the world, from London, to do Harinam every single day with book distribution and prasadam. The congregation members, with their help, we could fulfill Srila Prabhupada's dream of having this big temple in central London.
So the more that especially those who live outside become very strict and very dedicated and take responsibility within the temple, then we will begin to see things flourish far beyond our expectations.
Well, my dream is we have three separate altars, one for Radha Krishna, a large Radha Londonishvara as we have now, and small Radha Krishna. Another altar, we have big Gaunitai with our present Gaunitai. And on the third altar, we have Lord Jagannath. We have a smaller Lord Jagannath, and in that way you just increase the grandeur of the worship.
So there's great opportunity for involvement of our congregation to do something very positive with their lives, to become involved in this project.
Because I feel that at some point actually the temple will outgrow even this, and that, like you see nearby in Oxford Street and along Oxford Street, you have these language schools and computer schools and things. And so I can foresee that at some point we will expand to a place like that.
And that's my desire, actually, that we make this temple looking really, really beautiful and very attractive for people to come in. And when they, you know, stand in front of the building, that they will really feel like, oh, I want to go inside and see what's happening inside.
And I feel very strongly that for such an important city, for such an important movement, we should have a temple that is speaks to the world of importance. In other words, a huge, very big temple complex that includes, right in the middle of London, right in the central of London, not outside, but center of London, with enough space to accommodate a couple of hundred devotees, with a hostel. Both Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati and Srila Prabhupada wanted a hostel in central London, many classrooms for teaching courses, a theater. Srila Prabhupada said that we could conquer the English by theater, an auditorium, a library where people can come and sit and peacefully and quietly study Srila Prabhupada's books, a boutique, and now, of course, we have our restaurant, which really is more like a cafe than a restaurant. But I would like to see that we have different levels of eating establishments for people. Also, I envision that this complex would have gardens within it, and a parking garage for our congregation to come and visit. And of course, this would, what we're talking about is a very, very big space in which to do this. Just off the top of my head, I would say something like at least the size of Trafalgar Square. In fact, Trafalgar Square would be a good spot. And maybe even another facility we could have in this complex would be a helicopter pad. And thank you to all of you who are helping us make the Hare Krishna movement a big success in London. Hare Krishna. We have to wake up. Go and get the mercy. Come on, come on. By chanting Krishna's holy name. Come on, come on. By chanting Krishna's holy name. Wake up, sleeping soul.